Now let us continue to uncover more of the inner classes. I'll just modify a little bit of this code and declare a private variable, say x. So I'll create, just remove everything, and I can say in the show of inner, and I'll just attach x to this. And I'll just call show. So what I've done is I've created a private variable in the class outer one, and in a method of inner class called show, I'm trying to print out the value x. So let us see what output do we get. So it gives us in show of inner 10. So it is perfectly able to access the variable x, which is private in outer one. Now in our last lecture we had discussed that inner classes, they are implemented as full-fledged top level classes. So this means that we have a separate class outer, we have a separate class inner. And as we are aware that private variable in one class cannot be accessed by any other class, but in this case we are able to access the variable x through another class which is inner, whereas x is declared in a class outer which is separate from inner. So we are able to access a private variable from another class. So how this is possible? So now this is just because an agreement we have made between outer class and inner class that everything of the outer class is accessible from the inner class. So in order to go through this agreement, what we have done is to provide access to this variable x, the compiler generates a package access method. I'll just put down a comment. So what the compiler does is it provides a method similar to void access, say $000, and this is say x. So this will return x. So we are not directly accessing the variable x, but rather through a method that is generated by the compiler, and this x is accessed through a reference to the outer class. As we had seen in our last lecture that the compiler, while implementing these top level classes outer and inner, it stores a reference to the outer class in the inner class. So there will be a reference similar to this $0 referring to the outer class. So through this variable we can access the x, but by calling a method similar to access 000. So I'll just copy this code just to see what is being generated by the compiler in the class file. So I'll save this file. Copy it to my DOS. Compile it. And let us see what has generated for the two classes. So I'll just see Java P minus C and outer one. So see what outer one has done. This is the constructor. This is the method show. And this is the method access $000, which returns int as the return type. So this int is the value of x that we are looking at, and this you can see here it writes field x. So this is returning the value of x through a method which is access 000 and has an access level of package, and this is a static method. So in case we see the inner class Java or class file, outer one dollar inner, we can see in the method show, wherever we are accessing the variable x, it is referring to that as outer one dot access dollar 000. So this is how we are implementing the access of private variables of the outer class in the inner class through these accessor methods that the compiler generates in the outer class. So as we do for a normal class, if I have a private variable x, I provide a method similar to int getx and I say return x. So similar to that, the compiler has generated a simple method static, so that we don't need object of this class. It says int and a name which is similar to access $000, and it returns x. So wherever in the inner class we refer to x, it simply says outer one dot access 00. So this is the way how we are able to access any private variable of outer class in the inner class, as after compilation they are no longer outer and inner, they are both separate classes, and in separate classes as per rules we cannot access a private variable directly. So we have provided the access through a creation of a method which returns the value of the variable that we have declared. So this is another unraveling of a mystery of how private variables are accessed in inner classes.